Hey, what's up? Welcome to Hooson. In this video, you will be learning how to make codeless in-app purchases in Unity. After we are done, I will walk you through the process of connecting it with the App Store Connect and Google Play Store. Alright, let's begin. The first thing we need to do is to configure our game project. Head over to the File tab at the top left-hand corner of Unity and click on Build Settings. Make sure you are set to either iOS or Android platform. Once you have configured your game project, it's time to enable the Unity IAP service. Head over to the Window tab at the top of Unity, General, and then Services. In the Services window, you can see that in-app purchasing is currently turned off right now, so let's click on it, and we need to create a project ID for our game. If you have already created one, you can link this project to that project ID as well. I don't have a project ID yet, so I'm going to create a new one. Let's select an organization first, and then click on Create Project ID. Now they will ask you, will your app be primarily targeted to children under age 13? I will choose no for this tutorial, but if your game is targeted towards children, choose the yes option. Click Save, and as you can see, the in-app purchasing settings hasn't been turned on yet, so click on it to enable Unity IAP service. Once it finishes loading, you can see that it has been turned on. And now, we need to install the purchasing package into our game project. In the purchasing package section, click on Install Latest Version. Once it finishes loading, we now need to import the Unity IAP package into our project. In the Welcome section, click on Import. Once you have finished importing the package, a new folder called Plugins will be automatically added to your project. This folder contains the Unity purchasing asset, which is required to use Unity IAP. Now we can begin implementing Unity in-app purchases into our project. Firstly, let's create an empty game object called IAP Manager. Next, I'm going to create 3 IAP buttons under the IAP Manager game object. To add an IAP button to your scene, right-click on the Hierarchy tab, and you should see a Unity IAP section. And we want to create an IAP button. One for consumable product, one for non-consumable product, and the last button will be Restore Purchases. So a consumable product is one that a user consumes to receive in-game content. A great example of a consumable are in-game currencies like gems or coins. On the other hand, a non-consumable product is a product that is purchased once and provides a permanent benefit. Good example of a non-consumable product would be skins or remove ads. Once the player purchased these products, it will be permanently associated with the player's account. Lastly, the Restore Purchases button allows players to transfer in-app purchases to other devices such as new iPhone. The Restore button is only required on the App Store Connect. If you are just publishing your game on Google Play Store, you can remove this Restore Purchases button. Let's select our consumable button, and right now, we need to add our product. Let's click on the IAP Catalog button. The IAP Catalog window will pop up, and this is where we will add our product. I'm going to create my consumable product first, and I will be using 500 coins as my consumable product for this tutorial. So there is a specific format for naming our product ID. It starts with com. Your company name or individual name, and this will depend on how you register your developer account with Google and Apple. If you register as an individual, use your own name. If you register as a company, use your company's name. The name of the game. The name of the product. So if I register as a company, it will be like com. Hooson Technology, which is my company name, .IAP Tutorial, which is the name of my game, .coin500, which is my product name. Another example will be com.json, which is my name, .botattack, which is the name of my game, .coin500, which is my product name. So if players were to buy this product, they will be receiving 500 coins. The type of product will be consumable. For the title, I'm going to just name it 500 coins, and for the description, you can give a short explanation on what this product is about. So in my case, it will be something like gives the player 500 coins. Now let's expand the Google configuration and Apple configuration section. And we want our price to be the same in both Google Play Store and App Store Connect. If you click on the price tier, you can see many different options. Select a price for your product and make sure you enter the same amount in the Google configuration section as well. Since I selected $9.99 for the App Store, I'm going to put $9.99 for the Google Play Store. One last important step to take note, we need to check the automatically initialized Unity purchasing option. Alright, let's close the IAP catalog window. And I'm going to assign the product ID to my consumable IAP button. Make sure the button type is set to purchase. Alright, as you can see in my game project, I've created a title text and description text. So right now, I'm going to assign the title to the title text and description to the description text. And lastly, the button text to the price text. And when I click on the play button, the title, description, and price will be automatically added for me. This is one of the many benefits of using the Codeless IAP. Now let's create another product ID for our non-consumable purchase. I'm going to select the non-consumable button and open up the IAP catalog window again. Let's add a new product. This time round, I'm going to name my product ID com.hoosontechnology.iaptutorial.removeads. Remember to change the product type to non-consumable. Title will be remove advertisement. Description will be all ads will be permanently removed. Let's set the price for our remove advertisement product. Select a price from the Apple configuration section first, and then key in the same price on the Google configuration section. Once you are done, close the IAP catalog window, and with the non-consumable IAP button selected, I will change the product ID to the remove advertisement ID. Let's assign the title, description, and price tags as well. Lastly, select the Restore Purchases button, and we want to change the button type to Restore. That's all you need to do for the Restore Purchases button. Now when you click Play, you should be able to see your consumable product, non-consumable product, and Restore Purchases button implemented in the game. Now that we have implemented our IAP button, we need to create a new C# script to actually give the players the product they have bought in your game. So let's create a new C# script called IAP Manager and open it up. Go ahead and delete the start and update function as we won't be using it, and we want to add the UnityEngine.purchasing namespace. Next, we need to create two functions for our IAP button. Create a public function called onPurchaseComplete with a product parameter, and a public function called onPurchaseFailed with a product and purchase failure reason parameter. Next, we need to create two string type variables to store our product ID. So my first variable will be called coin500, and I'm going to copy and paste my coin500 product ID into it. Now I'm going to create another one called removeAds, and then copy and paste my removeAds product ID into it. Head over to the onPurchaseComplete function. And this is the function we want to call when the players successfully paid for the product. We will just use a simple if statement to check which product the players bought. So if product.definition.id equals to coin500, I'm going to reward the player with 500 coins. Since this is just a tutorial, I will just debug.log, you have gained 500 coins. In your actual game, this is where you should be rewarding your players. If product.definition.id equals to remove ads, I will just debug.log all ads removed. In the onPurchaseFailed function, we want to show the reason why the product wasn't bought successfully. So let's debug.log product.definition.id failed because failure reason. Save the script and head back to Unity. Attach the IAP Manager script to the IAP Manager game object, and we want to call the onPurchaseComplete function when the purchase is successful, and call the onPurchaseFailed function when the purchase isn't successful. Let's do the same for the other IAP button as well. Once you are done, it's time to click play and give it a try. Alright, perfect. The coin IAP button is working well, and as you can see, it says here, you have gained 500 coins. Let's try the remove ads IAP button. Alright, perfect. You can see that it says all ads removed. You have learned how to implement a consumable IAP button and a non-consumable IAP button. I have another additional step for the restore button for those who want to publish their game on both App Store Connect and Google Play Store. If you are just publishing your game for Google Play Store, you can skip to the connecting with Google Play Store part of the video. Alright, for those who want to publish on both App Store and Google Play Store, let's finish up the last step before we connect to the specific store itself. Open up the IAP Manager script again, and we want to create a new public game object called Restore Button. Create an awake function, and in the awake function, we want to check if the player is on an iPhone or Android device. So if the player is not on an iPhone, we want to disable the Restore Button game object, because the Restore Button is only needed for iPhone users. Alright, save the script and head back to Unity. Let's assign our Restore Button, and right now, I'm going to test on an iPhone, and you can see that the Restore Button is still here. Let's change to an Android phone and try it out. Alright, perfect. The Restore Button has been disabled. Alright, we are done with the IAP implementation. So all that's left to do is to connect it with the Google Play Store and App Store Connect. To connect our in-app purchases to Google Play Store is actually really simple. Firstly, let's open up our IAP catalog window again, and at the bottom, you can see an App Store export button. Let's click on it, and we want to select Google Play CSV. Save it somewhere in your computer, and we want to head over to the Google Play console. Once you are in the Google Play console, click on your app, and we want to head over to the in-app products section. One thing to take note, you will only be allowed to create in-app products on Google Play console only after you have uploaded your game over here. Simply click on the import button, and we want to import the file we saved earlier into the Google Play console. Let's click on import, and that's all you have got to do. You can see the status is set to active, and when I view the in-app product, you can see the name, description, and price has been automatically added for me. Alright, one extremely important thing to take note, if you take a look at the price of the products, you will notice that it's actually in Singapore currency, which is the country I'm from. So if I want it to be in US dollars, I actually need to convert the currency myself on Google Play Console. For those living in the States, you don't have to worry about the pricing, but for those living outside of United States, it's actually a little bit more troublesome for us as we need to convert our own currency to USD. Alright, we are done connecting our in-app purchases with Google Play Console. So for those who want to publish on the App Store Connect as well, let's continue with this tutorial. Alright, in the App Store Connect, the first thing we need to do is to head over to the Agreements, Tags, and Banking section, because in order to have in-app purchases on the App Store Connect, we must agree to the Free Apps and Paid Apps agreement. Once you are done, head over to your app on the App Store Connect, and on the left, you will see an in-app purchases section, and we want to click on Manage. Let's click on the plus icon to add our in-app purchases. I'm going to start with my consumable product first, and click on Create. For the reference name, we can just put the title of our product, which in my case is 500 coins. The product ID is extremely important. We want to copy our product ID in Unity and paste it here. Make sure you copy the correct product ID. For the pricing, just follow the tier you selected in Unity. So Apple has their own conversion rate for every country's currency. So even though you see it says here SGD $14.98, which is the Singapore dollars, it's actually the same as USD $9.99. The display name will be the title of our product back in Unity, and the description will be our description back in Unity as well. Head down to the review information section, and Apple requires us to provide a screenshot and brief description of our IAP button. So let's head back to Unity to screenshot our IAP button. So there is a specific dimension for our screenshot which Apple requires, which is 640 by 920 pixels. So it's actually really simple. If you take a look at your game tab, you will be able to see different options of aspect ratio available. So simply add a new aspect ratio. For the label, we will just name it screenshot. The width will be 640 and the height will be 920. Now we want to maximize our game window and make sure the scale is at 1. Next, simply use a snipping tool on your computer and crop this area out. Do make sure your screenshot is exactly 640 by 920 pixels, else you won't be able to upload it successfully. If you are having trouble uploading it on the App Store Connect, it's most probably your screenshot isn't in the correct size. So simply use any picture editing software to make your screenshot exactly 640 by 920 pixels. Once your screenshot is uploaded, simply give a brief description on the IAP button. Example would be, it is the first button in our store, it will give the player 500 coins. Once everything is done, simply click save and I'm done for my consumable product. Alright, now let's add another in-app purchases for our non-consumable product. The reference name will be remove advertisement. Copy the product ID in Unity and paste it here. Make sure you copy the correct product ID. For the pricing, just follow the tier you selected back in Unity. The display name will be the title of our product back in Unity, and the description will be our description back in Unity as well. Head down to the review information section. I'm going to use the same screenshot, and the review notes will be something like, it is the second button in our store, it will remove all ads. Alright, we are done in the App Store Connect. Only thing left for you to do is to send these in-app purchases together with your app for Apple to review it. So that's all for this video. Do click the like and subscribe button if you enjoyed this video. I will be posting more Unity tutorial and behind the scene of my game dev journey in the future as well. Also, do check out my first ever mobile game that I published for Android and iOS called Bot Attack. Link to download Bot Attack will be in the description below. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.